Okay, and this is our dry cell model HS2000. Now we are feeding electrolytes to the dry cell. As you can see, the measurement is the same, 19 by 19 centimeters. Only the width is 8 centimeters with the bolts. So now we will power it up. We will connect the wires. This dry cell has 6 plates, 1 positive, 1 negative, and 4 neutral plates. Okay, now we release power to the dry cell. Voltage is increasing, respectively the amperes is increasing also. And here we go, it starts producing gas, as you can see. This dry cell also can go up to 30 amps, but do not exceed 25. In real conditions in a vehicle. So now from the reservoir the gas is going to the dry cell, from the dry cell is going produced gas to the reservoir where it's separating from the water, and then the gas is going to the bubbler as well, and then it's going to the engine's intake. The vacuum of the engine will suck the oxy-hydrogen gas inside the cylinders where it will be burnt. So this kit, HS2000, can help you save on fuel and save on emissions. Usually we are using dynamic PWM, this device here, which is very compact and it's digital, so it's doing all control about amperes, about voltage. It's controlling it automatically. So you don't have to do anything. Of course, when you use such a device like the dynamic PWM, there is two models for the dynamic PWM, for diesel engines and for petrol injection engines. But we will talk in another video about the dynamic PWM. That's all for today from us. And if you like this video, just give us a like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.